It is the last week of term, and for many of us, it is hard to believe that it is Christmas time already. The school holidays and the end of another year, one which we won't forget, are once again upon us. It feels as though this time of year comes so quickly, and all of a sudden our lives are turned upside down with so much to get done before the big day, and then it is all over before we know it. Sometimes it is hard to be fully present in the moment, when we are overwhelmed and stressed about buying gifts, preparing the home and juggling our families through it all. So it helps to step back and take it all in. Slow down and enjoy Christmas and the holidays. Make this Christmas count for yourself, your family and for the many who struggle at this time of year. Make time for others. The good deeds you do will not only help others, but they will allow you to experience the real reason why we celebrate Christmas. Let the Christmas spirit guide you in all you do and say, and may happiness be guided to your home by the joy and goodwill of Christmas.
Twelve months have passed since we celebrated our carol service. We certainly didn't know then what was in store for the year ahead. COVID-19 has made the year 2020 one we will all remember. We faced many challenges, including lockdown in March, teaching and learning from home, and reopening a school as safely as we possibly could. We rose up to those challenges, and as a school community came together to face this pandemic head on. For some, it has been a time filled with grief as people they loved became seriously ill and in the worst cases died. It has also been a time for reflection and growth. We found hidden depths as we learned to find joy in the simple things in life, like going for walks, baking with our family, and doing Zoom calls and quizzes with family and friends. The caring and compassionate values we hold most dear in our school have been visible for all to see. There has been tremendous support for the annual concern fundraising events, with €5,000 already collected. A further €1,000 was raised for both the Irish Hospice Foundation and Team Hope. Even in these challenging times, we are still able to reach out to those most in need. In doing so, we are living out the Christian ethos of our school and actively spreading the true meaning of Christmas. I ask all of you to take time during this holiday to take stock of how far we have come. I want to sincerely thank all of you for your support, kindness and positivity. Leading a school at this time is filled with difficulties, but all of you have made it possible. I wish you the most joyful Christmas, and I look forward to seeing you all in school again in the new year.
St. Paul's letter to Corinthians speaks about how love is kind and never boastful. It is one we often hear at weddings because it is about the importance of love and therefore appropriate at weddings. Today we would like to share with you a Christmas version of a well-known reading from St. Paul. If I decorate my house perfectly with pretty bows, strands of twinkling lights and shiny stars, but do not show love to my family, then I am just another decorator. If I slave away in the kitchen, baking dozens of Christmas cookies and preparing gourmet meals, but do not show love to my family, I am just another cook. If I work in a soup kitchen, volunteer my time at the local nursing home, and give all that I have to charity, but do not show love for my family, it profits me nothing. If I fill my tree with shimmering angels and knitted snowflakes, go to all the Christmas parties and sing in Christmas carol service, but do not focus on Christ, I have missed the point. Love stops the cooking to hug the child. Love sets aside the decorations to say a kind word. Love is generous even when busy and tired. Love doesn't envy another's home that has coordinated Christmas china and table linens. Love doesn't yell at the kids to get out of the way. Love doesn't give only to those who are able to give in return. Love rejoices in giving to those who cannot. Love bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never fails. Video games will break, pearl necklaces will be lost, golf clubs will rust, but giving the gift of love will endure. May Christmas morning make us happy to love, and Christmas evening bring us to rest with grateful thought for giving, forgiven, and loved. Amen.
Coming on. A reading from Luke's Gospel. Today a Saviour has been born to you. Joseph set out from the town of Nazareth in Galilee and travelled up to Judea, to the town of David called Bethlehem, since he was of David's house and line, in order to be registered together with Mary, his betrothed, who was with child. While they were there, the time came for her to have her child, and she gave birth to a son, her firstborn. She wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them at the inn. In the countryside close by, there were shepherds who lived in the fields and took it in turns to watch their flocks during the night. The angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone round them. They were terrified, but the angel said, "Do not be afraid. Listen, I bring you news of great joy, a joy to be shared by the whole people. Today in the town of David, a Saviour has been born to you. He is Christ the Lord. And there is a sign for you. You will find a baby wrapped in swaddling clothes and lying in a manger." And suddenly with the angel, there was a great throng of the heavenly host, praising God and singing, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and peace to men who enjoy his favour." Now when the angels had gone from them into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has made known to us." So they hurried away and found Mary and Joseph and the baby lying in the manger. When they saw the child, they repeated what they had been told about him, and everyone who heard it was astonished at what the shepherds had to say. As for Mary, she treasured all these things and pondered them in her heart. And the shepherds went back, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen. It was exactly as they had been told, the Gospel of the Lord.
Save us sons and daughters.
With the light of Christ shining on us, let us pray to God for our own needs and the needs of all our world.
As we prepare to celebrate Christmas, may we remember the important gifts that we are blessed with: family, friends, health, food, and loved ones. Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all who are affected by coronavirus through illness or isolation or anxiety, that they may find relief, peace of mind, and recovery. Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for those who are guiding our nation at this time and shaping our national policies, that they may make wise decisions, and we as a people of kindness will support their judgments through our actions and our choices. Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for peace. Let us pray for the whole world, and especially for our own country, that this Christmas we may see more clearly that peace comes not through violence, bitterness, and hatred, but through love, forgiveness, and reconciliation. May we bless one another with peace and hope. Lord, hear our prayer.
Back again. There's something back to say. our school community. We pray for all the students and staff members of our school. We give thanks for the commitment and dedication of all our staff. We ask for blessings on all of us and our families this Christmas. Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all who find Christmas a difficult time of year, the poor and needy, the sick and the homeless, and those who will spend Christmas alone. Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for safety on our roads. We remember those who are travelling home this Christmas. We pray that they may reach their destination safely. Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all who have died. We pray especially for staff and students who have lost family and loved ones throughout this very difficult year. Let us now pause for a moment and remember all our deceased family and friends who have passed away. Lord, hear our prayer.
God of love and mercy, may the coming of your Son scatter the darkness of the world and make it radiant with his light. May we follow him faithfully and come to the light that shines forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen.
This is my winter song.
As our current service comes to a close and we look forward to the Christmas holidays and a well-deserved break, let us commit ourselves to be people who bring more light than darkness into this world. Help us to give something back to our families and our communities this Christmas season, and to remember the importance of having a generous heart. Bless our whole school community, our family and our friends. May the hope, peace, joy and love of Christmas be with you and your loved ones. Stay safe, protect one another, and have a peaceful and happy Christmas. This we ask to Christ our Lord. Amen.